I think for any online course, when you're using materials, it's a little too easy to go out and find an image and put that in and have it stand for what you want to say, or bring in a journal article or anything like that. But you have to give credit where credit's due. So you do have to show the copyright, where you access the information, and let the students know, because frankly, it's modeling good behavior. It's what we want to see them do. So I think it's critically important to do that. For instance, if I have an assignment that I saw another professor in my field do with their class, often I will modify the assignment instructions to fit my needs. But at the bottom, I'll put a copyright and adapted from and the source where I got it from. Because again, if I'm asking my students to cite their sources, I think it's very important that we do the same thing. Images, that gets tricky. You have to make sure the Google search isn't going to get you copyright free or open educational resource images. So you have to be very, very careful about using those and making sure that you get permission from the original site to utilize that photograph or image. Certainly if it's a picture you took yourself, that's a different thing. It definitely hits on it, but we're so habitual in that practice. We do it in our social media feeds all the time. Oh, this is a cool thing, let me share it, without attribution. But in an online course, in a formal setting, that's just not okay. And again, it's the modeling good behavior for the students.